Good morning, students. Today we are going to start new chapter, that is sequence and series. So in this chapter, let us first understand what do you mean by a sequence. A sequence is a set of numbers which are arranged in a particular order by some assigned law. Sequence kya hai? It is a set of numbers which are arranged by some law, according to some law. Like we have written 1, 2, 3, 4. So what we are observing, these are the set of nature numbers in which every number is the successor of the preceding one. 2, 4, 6, 8, it is a sequence of even numbers. They are satisfied, all the members of this list, they are satisfying the condition that they are divisible by 2. 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, this is the sequence of prime numbers. All are having only two factors, 1 and itself. This is another sequence in which we observe that from third term onward, every term is the sum of preceding two terms. So this type of sequence is called the Fibonacci sequence. Now, the nth term of a sequence is called its general term. जो nth term है उसे हम general term कहेंगे और उसको हम generally an या tn से represent करते हैं. और अगर कोई sequence finite है, जैसे हमारी ये second sequence है, ये finite है, it is having a finite number of terms, so it is called finite sequence. Otherwise, it is called infinite sequence, like sequence 1, 3rd and 5th sequence, they are infinite sequence. Then, sequences which follow specific pattern, they are called progressions. Like you have studied arithmetic progression in class 10th, they are following some specific pattern. Like in AP, you have studied that the difference of any two consecutive terms is constant. So such type of sequences, they are called progressions. In this class 11th, we will study one more progression, that is geometric progression. Then series. What is series? If a1 a2 an is a given sequence, then the expression a1 plus a2 plus a3 up to an and so on, this will be called a series corresponding to this sequence. And if the corresponding sequence is finite, the series is called finite. If the corresponding sequence is infinite, the series will be called infinite series. So let us do the exercise. This is the first question of the exercise. Find the first five terms of the sequence whose nth term is given by n into n plus 2. जनरल टर्म हमें दे दी है, इससे हमें शुरू की पांच टर्म्स फाइंड आउट करनी है. तो n को एक बार 1 रखिए, फर्स्ट टर्म आ जाएगी. n को 2 रखिए, सेकेंड टर्म, एंड लाइक वाइज अप टू n इक्वल टू 5. सो वेन यू पुट n इक्वल टू 1, वी गेट 1 इंटू 1 प्लस 2, दैट इज 3. इट मीन्स द फर्स्ट टर्म ऑफ द सीक्वेंस इज 3. पुट n इक्वल टू 2, यू विल गेट 2 इंटू 2 प्लस 2, दैट इज 8. दिस इज सेकेंड टर्म, एंड लाइक वाइज you put n equal to 3, 4 and 5, then we will get the terms as 15, 24, 35. So the corresponding sequence is 3, 8, 15, 24 and 35. This is another part of this question in which general term is given by an equal to minus 1 to the power n minus 1 into 5 raised to the power n plus 1. So, pehle n ko 1 rakha, then becomes minus 1 to the power 1 minus 1 into 5 to the power 1 plus 1, and minus 1 to the power 0 is 1, so it becomes 5 to the power 2, that is 25. Put n equal to 2, you will get माइनस वन टू द पावर टू माइनस वन इंटू फाइव टू द पावर टू प्लस वन, दैट बिकम्स माइनस फाइव क्यूब, सो इट इज माइनस 125. एंड लाइकवाइज यू विल फाइंड थर्ड फोर्थ एंड फिफ्थ टर्म बाय पुटिंग n इक्वल टू 3, 4 एंड 5. And then write all the terms in the form of a sequence. This is the next question. Write the first five terms of the sequence and obtain the corresponding series. Here, the first term is given as 3. And after the first term, every term is defined by this expression, an equal to 3 times a n minus 1 plus 2, means 3 times of the preceding term plus 2 for n equal to greater than 1, means for n equal to 2, 3, 4 and so on. The terms, they are defined by this expression. So we put n equal to 2. When you put n equal to 2, you will get a2 equal to thrice of a1, thrice of preceding term plus 2. And a1 is 3, so it becomes 3 into 3 plus 2, that is 11. Similarly, put n equal to 3, then you will get a3 equal to thrice of a2 plus 2. And a2 is 11, so put a2 equal to 11, so you get 3 into 11 plus 2, that is 35. Likewise, you can find n for n equal to 4 and 5, that is 4th and 5th term, you will get the sequence as 3, 11, 35, 105 and 323. Then corresponding series will be 3 plus 11 plus 35 plus 105 plus 323. Next one is, the Fibonacci sequence is defined by in which the first two terms, they are 1, and all the terms after that, they are defined by the sum of preceding two terms, that is an equal to an minus 1 plus an minus 2 for n greater than 2. N greater than 2 matlab for n equal to 3, 4, 5 and 6. The terms, they are defined by this. Abhi humne ek last example jo liya tha, jab aapko sequence samjhaya, usme ye Fibonacci sequence hi likhi thi humne. To hame ये रेशो फाइंड आउट करना है ए एन प्लस वन अपॉन ए एन फॉर एन इक्वल टू वन टू थ्री एंड अप टू फाइव. तो एन इक्वल टू थ्री पुट करेंगे और इस एक्सप्रेशन से हम ए थ्री की वैल्यू फाइंड आउट करेंगे. सो ए थ्री इज इक्वल टू ए टू प्लस ए वन, और ए टू और ए वन दोनों वन हैं, सो ए थ्री बिकम्स टू. अब हम ए फोर फाइंड आउट करेंगे, तो ए फोर विल बी द सम ऑफ ए थ्री एंड ए टू. एन को 4 रखा तो ए थ्री प्लस ए टू आ जाएगा, और मीन्स प्रीवियस टू टर्म्स का सम, और प्रीवियस टू टर्म्स हमारे 2 और 1 हैं, सो इट बिकम्स 3. लाइकवाइज एन इक्वल टू 5 और 6 रखेंगे आप, तो ए फाइव और ए सिक्स आ जाएगा, क्योंकि एन इक्वल टू 5 तक हमें इसकी वैल्यू चाहिए, तो लास्ट में ए सिक्स भी चाहिए हमें, क्योंकि न्यूमरेटर ए सिक्स हो जाएगा. सो इस वी हैव फाउंड द टर्म्स अप टू ए सिक्स by adding the previous two terms. Then we find the ratio. So for n equal to 1, the ratio becomes a2 divided by a1, that is 1 by 1, 1. For n equal to 2, it becomes a3 divided by a2, that is 2 by 1. Jab n ko 4 rakhenge, to ye a4 ban gaya, divided by a3, that is 3 by 2. Isi tarah se n ko 4 rakhenge aur n ko 5, then you will get the corresponding ratio. That's all for today. Thank you.